This is a production of PBS 39.
You know, it's that time of year when it's really nice to just curl up with a good book. And on Tempo, we love to bring you some local authors who have new books to talk about. And we have one joining us right now, Jenny Pascal. Jenny, thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
But you have your first novel out called Steffi, which has really been receiving fabulous reviews. Mm-hmm. It's quite a hysterical story of friendship. Why don't you tell us a little bit about Steffi and her friend?
Well, it's a story of two women, Steffi and Sue. Steffi is a younger woman. She's 24, and she's very much a free spirit. And she meets Sue, who is trying to get her life together. She's a very together person. She's got a career, but she never quite gets her relationships right. And she's somebody who kind of gets herself stuck. She's always trying to please everybody else. Sue is 42. Steffi kind of says to her, kind of gives her a little shove every now and then in a direction that she's not sure she wants to go in. And she ends up getting Sue into situations that Sue wouldn't have dreamt of ever getting into. And then she has to get herself out of them or resolve them in some way. And
they travel all over the globe. This doesn't just take place in one location.
No, it starts in London, and they go to India. They go to India and Nepal. And they see some pretty wondrous sights and some very touching sights. And Sue grows as a result of both the friendship and the journey. And at the end of the book, which obviously I can't reveal, but she's a slightly different person from the woman at the beginning. But it's also a good romp. You know, it's a little raunchy, and hopefully it's funny, and they get themselves into some pretty wild situations.
You've mentioned that these days you don't have to be a Sex and the City kind of person to have an exciting life. And that's something that women, you know, a nice 42-year-old, it's interesting to have some excitement, but still kind of be outside of the normal life. And that's how some folks have described this. Tell us more about that.
Well, yeah, I think that the thing about being, you know, reaching that age of 40, 42, 38, whatever it is, you know, you're sort of quite together about a lot of things. And life changes often because maybe it's a divorce or a long relationship ends, or the kids are growing up a little bit, they don't need you so much on a daily basis. And it's a time when women sometimes examine themselves and often think that they're wanting, you know, that there's life isn't quite the way they thought it was going to be when they were 18, 19. And you look at shows like Sex and the City and you think it's all about, you know, a really fancy, expensive pair of shoes and a gorgeous 6'4" boyfriend. And I wanted to write a story where it's a woman that perhaps we can all identify with, a woman who kind of says, oh, I don't think I can do this, and then actually she can, because she's really got it in her to do it. But most of us take that moment and we say, oh, I'm not sure. And this, because of Steffi, Sue finds herself leaping into the abyss more often than she'd perhaps choose, and finds that risks can be fun.
And it's a fun book, and it's receiving great reviews. But now, your first novel, but you've been a writer for over a decade, writing a lot of television. Yes. Ripley's Believe It or Not specials.
Yeah, I write a show like Ripley's Believe It or Not called Would You Believe It, which is for the Discovery Channel, and America's Most Haunted, and Best Places to Find UFOs, and Strangest Remains, which is all about weird body parts all over the world, and I've unwrapped mummies, and I write and produce those. So I've done some pretty held bell jars with heads in them and sort of had to carry them across huge areas in a museum, desperately hoping I'm not going to drop a 300-year-old head because I'm a klutz. So, and that's a bit of Sue too, you know, it's just sort of, oh my goodness, I know I'm going to show myself up.
So there's a little bit of you in this book as well.
There's quite a lot of me in it, yes.
Very exciting things, potential for a movie deal.
Yes, it's with a couple of actresses right now. One sort of major agent sort of seems to have fallen in love with the book and is giving it to some of her clients who are the right age.
First time novelist, we thank you so much. Wish you all the best with your new book, Steffi, and look forward to hearing about that movie deal actually happening.
Thank you so much. Thank you.